when it comes to breast cancer or the childhood cancer, in a high income country, the chance of survival is almost 90%. But in developing countries, it is only 10%. So that means technologies are available, medicines are available, or the treatment is, in a general, broadly speaking, the treatment technologies and products are available, but it is not available in the southern countries. There are two reasons for this unaffordability. One is the lack of generic competition compared to those medicines which are protected under the patent regime. And another second reason is that of regulatory barriers created to prevent the competition. So intellectual property and regulatory barriers are affecting the treatment to cancer. Because the moment people realize that there is a availability at an affordable price, say for example India or Brazil or China or Thailand, the medicine is available, is at a very affordable price. The same medicine is priced at a very high cost in developed countries or in Switzerland. Mm-hmm. Definitely people are going to point fingers at the Swiss government and the companies and would interrogate their policies. They don't want that to happen. So in a way, to protect their profit in North, these companies and the Swiss government is holding people's life at ransom. I think the people are the victims, irrespective of the country where they live, of the corporate exploitation or corporate's drive for profit. So I think through the pressure from the below, you can change things, and towards this purpose, the people in both developing and developing countries should join together through various civil society organizations or through social movements and push back against this corporate drive for profiteering. Or, you know, we should clearly convey the message that people's interest or people's health should be placed above the profit. The profit motives or the people should be placed before profit.